I don't even know how you make maple syrup.
Oh, well, all these trees are tapped. See right there?
Oh, I see.
Yeah, those trees are all tapped. Collect it into the barrels, put it over a fire. About 40 gallons of sap makes 1 gallon of syrup, depending on the sugar content.
So wow.
It could take upwards, it could take a really long time to boil it down. This was actually going to be our most productive, we call it a sugar bush, our most productive maple grove.
This is where you were tapping the...
Yeah, those are a lot of my maple trees. I haven't looked at this yet.
I'm sorry.
I haven't really wanted to.
In December 2014, the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, or FERC, granted eminent domain condemnation power to a fracked gas pipeline, the Constitution Pipeline, a joint project between the Williams and Cabot Oil and Gas Companies, two companies engaged in heavy fracking in northeast Pennsylvania. The ruling allowed the fracking companies to condemn property along the proposed pipeline route, even though the pipeline had yet to obtain necessary permits in Pennsylvania and in New York. Although the Holleran family and many other families opposed the eminent domain pipeline condemnation, a Pennsylvania judge upheld the ruling allowing chainsaw crews to start cutting down a wide swath of the Holleran family's maple trees, trees that they have tapped for many years to make maple syrup.
So this is the first time you're coming and seeing this?
Kind of just pretended not to the other day. Painted the American flags on there just to kind of symbolize, you know, you think this is America, but here we are.
And they're cutting these things down even though they have the flag on them.
Some of these trees are upwards of 200 years old. The old tree line at the other end of the property is, they're probably upwards of 200, 250 years old. They're irreplaceable. You know, these trees are, most of these trees are at the age where we'll never see anything like this regrow here in my lifetime, even if they said tomorrow you can have it back. The FERC is the agency that grants them basically public utility status through their Certificate of Public Convenience and Necessity. And that's what gives them the power to use eminent domain, and then the federal judge is the one who grants it specifically for our property.
Isn't it true, though, that this pipeline is quite possibly going to export the gas?
There's nothing about this pipeline that's a public utility. Eminent domain is supposed to be used to benefit the communities that it's impacting. Generally, it's supposed to be used to benefit the people it's impacting. No one in Pennsylvania or New York will ever see a benefit from this pipeline. And we've seen a lot of preparation to connect to the Iroquois pipeline and ship it to Canada, or to connect to another pipeline crossing Massachusetts, take it to a port and ship it to Europe.
Which would be not the proper usage of eminent domain.
It's completely illegal for a private corporation to use eminent domain to ship gas overseas to use for their own profit. There's nothing about that that is how the eminent domain law was intended to be used. That this is an injustice is the grossest understatement that possibly could be applied to the situation. This is terrifying. And anyone who lives in America and thinks that they own their home should be terrified by this. Whether they're anti-gas or pro-gas, or love pipelines or hate pipelines, it shouldn't matter. This is terrifying.
When the chainsaws get finished, 90% of the Holleran's maple grove will be cut down. They were bracing for the shock of having their maple trees cut down, but then the real shock arrived. The chainsaw crews were accompanied by U.S. Marshals sporting body armor and AR-15 assault rifles.
They're U.S. Marshals?
They're U.S. Marshals.
Who are U.S. Marshals?
I don't actually know. I don't know where they came from. I mean, I don't know if there's a barracks or if they shipped them in from somewhere. I don't want to know what it's costing the tax dollars
to
have a dozen of these guys here protecting the pipeline workers from my peace signs.
Were you surprised that U.S. Marshals with automatic weapons and body armor came here?
I was shocked. It was the most disproportionate thing they could have done. Every interaction we've had with them has been peaceful and respectful, and they showed up with assault rifles and bulletproof vests.
As of December 5th, 2012, the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission had received over 20 applications to build liquefied natural gas ports to ship American gas overseas. If the Constitution Pipeline connects to those terminals, it would be an abuse of the eminent domain law. But the problem of these pipelines is not just in this one section of New York or PA. In fact, there are hundreds of new frack gas power plants proposed, which would need hundreds of pipelines to bring them frack gas to burn. These pipelines, such as the NED pipeline, the AIM pipeline, the Millennium pipeline, the pipelines threaten to cut down hundreds of thousands of trees. But what's worse, the new frack gas power plants that they would enable would significantly worsen climate change and make the U.S. electricity grid dependent on frack gas for decades to come.
How does it make you feel when you look at this?
I can't look at this. I literally can't look at this. I won't be able to stay here all day while they're cutting trees.
Sure,
the sound of them falling, it was heartbreaking. It was absolutely devastating. And it is made that much worse by the fact that they make you helpless against it, and they do that intentionally. It works because I can't stop them. The people who make these decisions will never see my face. Mm-hmm. And the people who make these decisions don't have to.
Would you like to meet those people at FERC? They are the people who made the decision. Mm-hmm. Isn't that right?
I think it would be a game changer for us to get to meet those people.
Right.
Every single person that you ever will get to talk to when dealing with a pipeline company is able to say, that's not my fault. I don't make those decisions. You're not allowed to blame me. I would love to meet the people who I'm allowed to blame.
So he decided to go to FERC and see if they like pancakes, offering them love and maple syrup in exchange for exploitation, terror, and destruction.
Ain't gonna let the corporation turn us round. Keep on walking, keep on talking. Stop all of these pipelines now. Where the drilling?
These are the last jugs of maple syrup from maple trees that FERC cut down in Pennsylvania. And so we'd like to ask if FERC employees would come out and have some pancakes with us and some maple syrup. We'd like to turn all of that violence and exploitation into a little bit of pancake love.
Yeah.
We shall not be moved. We shall not be moved. Just for pancakes. More pancakes, less pipelines.
And we followed all the legal routes. We appealed to FERC. We intervened with FERC. We sent our comments into FERC. We asked them to have the pipeline wait until the project had been approved before they came and caused irreparable harm to our land and our business and our home. And the FERC denied us. The FERC ignored us. And they ignored all of my letters and responded with, it's not our problem. I would like to invite anyone working for the FERC, to come down and realize why this should be your problem. My problem should be yours, why my home should be you seeing your home in the decisions that you make, because this could happen to anyone.
But we're here today to prove that there is another way to be in this society, that we can have a paradigm of generosity, a paradigm of responding to the direct threats to Megan Holleran's family, to their property, to their business, responding with kindness, responding with an invitation to share the last of their maple syrup. This is a different paradigm that is on display here today, and we're asking FERC to come join that paradigm.
We have to put an end to the fossil fuels that are ruining our planet, that this is a moral imperative. This is about more than economics and science. This is about values. Let's take account, let's stand together, let's stand with the Hollerins, let's stand with all the families and communities that are being harmed by fracking and fracked gas.
We can't afford to think that what is happening now does not connect us all. It starts here with families losing generations of income and of knowledge and of culture by breaking these trees. And then it goes even further and wake up my lovely people of color. Because all of the waste that comes from this and the pollution that comes from it, 90% of it ends up in poor communities of color. Because they think that we won't say anything, and we don't.
Is there any representative of FERC that could come down and speak with us? So, I mean, this is exactly the... Hold on just a second.
Excuse me. Hi, can we talk?
Yes, we can talk. Okay. Absolutely. We would like to speak with the...
Okay, you know they're not going to meet with you. You know.
We'd like to deliver a message to FERC about the maple trees that they've cut down, but also a much broader message about climate change. FERC is engaged in destroying and disrupting communities, but they're also engaged in breaking the Paris Accords. Obama and John Kerry signed an accord that said we're going to try to keep climate change well below 2 degrees. If FERC continues to permit pipelines and power plants and compressor stations, there's absolutely no way we make that goal. Right now, we just like to deliver the payments. I think if they knew that we were coming to give them the last maple syrup of the trees that they cut down, they might...
I will relay your message.
You are.
I will talk to one of the security people.
That's so nice of you.
But I'm assuming that they may not come out to talk to you. Okay. All right. I'm trying to do is get somebody, one of their representatives, to come talk.
Okay, that's wonderful. Okay, that's great.
All right, can you allow people to get in and out while we're waiting for that? Commissioner's got coming
on. Tell them to come down and meet.
Yeah, we want to have pancakes with them.
We have a table and chairs.
We have a table set up, Aaron.
I asked for a rep. All right, the point is they're not going to meet with them. Okay.
What if they send a representative down?
I talked to their security guy. They're not going to meet with you. Okay. So based on that,
can we make an appointment?
Can we ask?
Well, are any of you guys employees of FERC coming down for lunch? We have a free lunch. Well, it's really breakfast, but you get a breakfast all day.
I don't get an official lunch break.
You don't get a lunch break.
This is work.
This is what we're doing. We're bringing in the lunch break.
No one from FERC would come down and face Megan Hollerin, so we decided to blockade the building.
Rising, oh, are you going to let us drown? Tell me now, which side are you on? Oh, which side are you on? Oh, which side are you on? Oh, which side are you on? But don't pollute our rivers. Oh, don't cut down our trees. Tell me now, which side are you on? Which side are you on? Which side are you on?
More information about the protests against the Constitution Pipeline, the NED Pipeline, and others can be found at Beyond Extreme Energy's website, beyondextremeenergy.org. Governor Andrew Cuomo's Department of Environmental Conservation can deny the Constitution Pipeline a water quality permit, stopping the project for now. Please visit stopthepipeline.org and consider attending a rally in Albany on April 5th. For more information, go to stopthepipeline.org, beyondextremeenergy.org, energyjustice.net, and howtoletgomovie.com.